Well, you already know this, but buyers and sellers are absolutely ignoring you as a real estate agent. In this quick video, we're going to talk a little bit about why. If you're not familiar with me, I'm Greg Luther. I coach 30,000 realtors at all different levels all over the United States. And you know, the number one thing I hear from agents when they come to me is, I'm getting plenty of leads. None of them will take my call. Those that do take my call say, I'm not interested, we're not serious, take me off your list, that type of thing. And when I'm sending emails, heck, I can't even get them opened anymore. I'm sure you've experienced the same thing. And you know, from some of the top producers that I work with all over the country, they've mitigated those problems and they've realized that it takes a lot more communication to get your message through to prospects today. So let me give you an example. If you look at your CRM, whichever CRM you're using, if you're sending emails on a regular basis to unconverted leads, to past clients, sphere of influence, that type of thing, we never call them past clients, we call them inactive clients. I can't imagine if my doctor ever said I'm a past patient of his, right? I just haven't been sick. I haven't needed you. So you never want to call them past clients. That's a bad, bad term to ever refer to them as, because frankly, they'd say, oh, well, if I'm a past client, then I can interview other agents, right? So we call them inactive clients. But regardless, I'm off topic. So much so, I just forgot what I was talking about. For communicating with them, if you look in your CRM, you will see that you have a 10% to maybe 12, 13% open rate on the emails you send out. So what that means is if you send 100 emails, only 12 of them were opened and read, which means 88 of them were lost in cyberspace, deleted, went into the spam box, not looked at, deleted, unread. As you know, a lot of people open their email and they just check, delete, right? They're not going through each one and then deleting them. They're getting deleted, unopened. So what you'll find is you're giving way too much credit to the amount of attention that your prospect is actually giving you in the first place. So at one of our live events that we did here recently, of course my phone starts ringing like crazy as soon as we start doing a training video here. But at one of the live events that I was at, I posed the question to the group and I said, if you were to try and get a seller or a buyer's attention, if you want to get their attention, you know they're a good lead, you got a good lead, but you're trying to get their attention so they'll pay attention to you, how many times do you think you need to email them? Let's say it is inactive clients or unconverted leads. How often do you think you need to email them, and how much is too much? Because there's definitely a fine line, right? You don't want to do it too much, you don't want to be overbearing, but if you don't do it enough, they're not going to work with you at all. So I posed the question, what if you emailed your entire list every week, every single Friday you send an email to them? Is that too much? Is that too little? Or is that just right? Now, I want you to think about the answer to that. If you emailed your list, unconverted leads, every single Friday, is that too much or is that too little? Because here's the bad news for you. Let's say you do that the very beginning of the year. January, first week, second week, third week, fourth week. February, first, second, third, fourth week. I think there's 4 weeks in February, 28 days. March, first, second, third, and fourth week. We're emailing every single Friday. You know what the bad news is? They've gotten one email from you in 2.5 months. Let me show you here. You have a 10% open rate. So of every 10 emails you send, they're only opening one. So every 10 weeks, they actually get an email from you. They open it, read it. I should say they open it, may read it, once every 2.5 months, once every 10 weeks. So every Friday is not enough in today's marketplace. You can see, you have data that shows you that you have a 10%, maybe 12% open rate. That is not contestable at all. That means 9 of every 10 emails sent do not get opened at all. So if you have like a drip email campaign that hits them once a month, you're in trouble, right? If you're calling leads and not getting through to them, do you know why that is? Because what happens is, I've got my cell phone right here. So what happens is my phone's ringing and I look at it. Well, it's not a program number. I can see it's a random number. First thing that goes through my head, is it a local area code? might be somebody important. Where's the kids right now, right? But what happens is I'm thinking, I know this is probably a robocall or a sales call. Hello? And who's at the other end? You, a salesperson. And you start with, hi, my name's Greg Luther. I'm with ABC Realty, and I got your request here for information on my website. No, thank you. Because I was pessimistic before I answered the phone when you called. And you know what I thought, what I was thinking in my head? I know it's a robocall or it's a salesperson. And I answered it, sure enough, it's a salesperson. And now you could say, but Greg, you requested this information. Doesn't matter, because they were pessimistic to begin with. So the reason your buyers and sellers are avoiding your calls, they're not opening your emails, you can't get anybody to reply. When you do get them on the phone, they're very standoffish or appear to be unmotivated. By the way, they're very motivated. They gave their personal information on the internet. Okay, they're very motivated. They don't act that way because of the way you're handling your calls. So I want to pose a question to you here in thinking about what should you do each and every day? What should you do to get their attention? What's the best medias to use, right? Email, highly ineffective. Phone, highly ineffective. Both required, but both are ineffective. So what other media can you use? What else can you do? You'd immediately think, well, I could do direct mail, right? Yeah, that works. I could do text message. Yeah, that works very well. There's a lot. I could do Facebook. Yeah, that works really well as well. But what you don't want to do is give way too much credit to the amount of attention that your buyers and sellers are giving you, because it's like that much. It's very little attention that they're giving you. So just because you send an email doesn't mean it gets opened. Again, if you send 100 emails, 10 get opened, 90 do not. If you have a 12%, let's go crazy. Let's say you have a 15% open rate, 15 opened it, 85 did not. So the best thing to do, by the way, little side tip for you, is tomorrow, take the 85 that didn't open it, send the same email to them with a different subject line. The subject line is your envelope, okay? If the envelope doesn't get opened, it's because the outside of the envelope didn't look good. Well, the subject line in an email is your envelope. Make the envelope look better, because they're looking at who's it from and what does the subject line say. And what you'll find is if you can get a 10% open rate on the first one and a 10 or 12% open rate on the second one, now we're talking 20, 25% open rate. But it does take a lot more work to make it happen. I'm actually preparing right now for our upcoming coaching retreat. 3 days we're going to be spending in a conference room going over what's working today. What do you need to change? How do we get their attention? How do you create an offer that actually makes sense for them? That is the key to success as a real estate agent. How do I get attention, and how do I have something that creates a magnetic response from them? They're magnetically attracted to whatever my offer is. But moral of the story here, the reason they're avoiding you, the reason your buyers and sellers aren't paying any attention to you is, number one, the message sucks. Number two, the messaging sucks, right? The method that you're using, the approach that you're using, not a good approach. So there's a lot you can do. I'll probably do a couple of videos on it here very soon on some of the things that are working really well. We track everything with some of our coaching members from all around the country, and we know what's working and what's not. So maybe I'll share some of that with you as well. So don't give too much credit to the amount of attention they're paying to you, and I can promise you, you need to do more. You need to email more. You need to call. I wouldn't even necessarily call more. I would text more. Video texting is working extremely well. Facebook retargeting through custom audience. Unbelievable how well that works, and it's easy to do. It's not technology. You don't need to shut down and say, oh my gosh, I don't want to learn anything new. I'm an old dog, right? That's what you're saying every time you say, I don't want to learn that. You're saying, I'm an old dog. You can't teach me any new tricks. Well, then you're as good as you're ever going to be, right? So the custom audience is working extremely well. Definitely a lot of things to think about in how you communicate with your leads, because the question is, why generate any leads at all if you're not going to convert them? It gives you the illusion of movement, but you never see any real movement on the bottom line, right? So anyway, start thinking about that a little bit. What are some better ways that you can communicate? If you have any questions for me, definitely reach out to us, support@gregluthercoaching.com. I see a lot of you have signed up for the weekly webinar as well. at gregluthercoaching.com. But again, I'd love to help you out, give you some information on that. But you really got to think about how you're communicating with these leads. You got to think about why they're treating you the way that they are. Why are they completely ignoring or not opening emails, not taking the phone calls, or when they do take the phone calls, they're standoffish. Is this helpful for you? Like the video here. Make sure you're following our page. As you know, we're on here every single day. We got a lot of information to share with you, and I want you to get some good information in growing your real estate business. So hopefully that's helpful. Go out there and sell some houses tonight. Let me know how I can help you. We'll talk soon, and bye-bye for now. Hey, I hope you enjoyed that video. And listen, we've got a lot more information for you to help you with growing your real estate business. We load new videos nearly every day, and I want you to have access. So you got to do two important things. It's both totally free. Number one, I want you to subscribe to this channel. You'll see the little subscribe button for you to click. If you don't have an account with YouTube, set it up. It's totally free. You got to subscribe to this channel. And the most important factor, you got to ring the bell. Right next to that subscribe button, you'll see a little bell to turn on notifications. That will let you know every time I load a new money-making video to help you with growing your real estate business. Subscribe and make sure you ring the bell. We'll see you in the next video.